Hey, everybody, it's 8 o'clock. We got a special Friday night show. It's pizza and beer night. So I hope you guys are joining us for pizza and beer. This is pretty awesome. We got Enrique Monroy talking about his hot sauce book. And you see, we got a bunch of hot sauces up here. We're going to try them all out on our pizza. And we're going to share everything we know about all the hot sauces that are going to be in the book. And everything to do with that. And I have to say, I want to give a big shout out to Etch and Sketch Glassworks. That's Etch and Sketch Glassworks with an X.com. They do a fantastic job. As you can see, they do amazing etching on glasses, on so much you can do with their products. You see all these different hot sauce companies. I had them on the screen here for you. So you can see there's so many different hot sauce companies that use Etch and Sketch Glassworks. Fantastic company. You can get these personalized for yourself, for gifts, for Christmas, for birthdays, whatever you want, for your own company to sell them. They can do it all for you. They not only can put it on glass, they can put it on all different types of products. They can etch and sketch your logo right on there. So give a big shout out for etchandsketchglassworks.com. All right, let's move on over to Enrique. Let's get him on. There he is. How are you today?
Damn good. How are you?
Good. You can see there's just a little bit delay in the Facebook feed from what we're at. How are you?
Yeah, I was trying to put that together. I'm doing good. How are you?
Good. Now, you got your pizza and beer to join us tonight?
Oh, yeah. I got some craft beers right here. Got a couple more on the ice. And got some pizza right here. I can't open the box because I got a surprise revealed underneath the lid, as you know.
Is everybody out there having pizza and beer with us? Get your glasses up and give us a toast out there. And I toast you there, my brother. Now,
thank you, man.
Where are you out of?
Thanks for everything you're doing, man.
Oh, absolutely. Where are you out of?
I'm out of Stockton, California.
So you're a little bit earlier than I am, so I'm getting you just about at dinner time then, aren't I?
Just about beer 30, I think.
Even better. We're all set up for that.
Oh, yeah.
Looks like we got a lot of people on here watching right now. And let's do us a favor and hit the share button so that everybody can see exactly what Enrique is doing. He's doing so much such a great service for the hot sauce community out there, and everybody needs to know what's going on. So hit that share button for us and share this on your page for everybody. We would really appreciate that. Now, right in the center of the table there, I see you have your sauce sitting right there.
Yeah, it's a mango habanero hot sauce.
Now,
it has a nice sweet.
Now, you can see that I don't have it set in here because it disappeared almost as soon as I got it. So that can give you a little bit that tell you how good it is. And saying that, just because these sauces are here doesn't mean I don't like them. It's just that I got more than one or I've reordered. And if the someone's sauce isn't up here, doesn't mean I don't like it. It's just that I'm all out. So we'll just put that out there for everybody.
Yeah, that's the same with, you know, the same with what I got here. You know, these are some of the entries in the book, and I wasn't trying to play favorites or anything. It's just obviously the amount that I have, it couldn't fit in this picture, so.
Exactly.
I just kind of picked a.
No, it looks like you got a good selection there. I see the skull there, Bobby Powers, is that correct?
Oh, yeah. Bloody Hell Hot Sauce.
That's...
Pretty amazing bottle, man.
Yeah.
That much.
He's got a skull like...
The unique thing about this guy is he said that he's originally from my area, and he sent this all the way from England, but he's from Oakland.
No kidding.
Yeah.
I got one of his sauces, and that's a pretty darn good sauce right there. It's got a real unique Caribbean-style flavor to it.
Nice. Yeah, I haven't been able to tap into it. I'm still using these for the book, so I'm not, you know, I can't really as tempting as it is, I can't really open them up right now.
Oh, yeah, you're suffering because I know how bad you want to dip into some of them. They're that good. Yeah. I'm going to start the night out with a little Cajon's Chipotle Habanero. I don't have a whole lot left. It's a great sauce. So I'm dipping on my pizza here, and we're going to try it. And I already know it's fantastic because I'm just about all of it out of it. How's everybody else out there doing? Everybody got their pizza, and what are you trying on your pizzas tonight?
Yeah, Cajon has a lot of great products. I mean, I can't even count how many because he has probably over 250 products. So, but they're all amazing. So.
Now, is Cajon any of his sauces in your book?
He said he's going to enter. I know that he's been busy with all these shows and different events coming up, so he's probably going to get back to me here in a minute.
Oh, I'm sure. Yeah. All right. You know, I'm talking about this book, and why don't you tell us what you have going on with it? Because I keep on mentioning it, and it's probably not really fair that I'm talking about it and people don't know. So tell us what you have going on with that.
So basically, I had this vision on creating this book to shine light on the industry. I think that, you know, there's a lot of hard work and dedication and sacrifices that go on in this industry. And unfortunately, this industry isn't as big as it should be. You know, I think it should be as big as craft beer, to be honest.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's just not there yet. So, you know, I'm just doing everything I can. I'm just a small guy, too, you know, hot sauce maker. And I'm just trying to shine light on that and give everyone kind of credit and give them a home, you know. So that's my whole vision on creating this book.
I totally agree with you about that because that's basically what Tasting the Heat is. We're trying to we fell in love with this industry and the spicy food, you know, that everybody loves. And there's a reason for it, and that's exactly what we do, and I was so happy to see you putting out this, because then people have something tangible they can hold right in their hand and keep it right with them at all the times and share it with their other friends. Hey, check this book out. This is amazing.
Exactly. You know, I want it to be, like, eventually a source where people go to figure out what kind of sauce they haven't tried, you know, from all over the world. So, and I know that this is, like, this is the first volume that I'm coming out with, but so I'm not going to have everyone in the industry involved in it, but I do have a good backing. I love everyone that has sent their stuff in and have supported the concept of the book. I think it's going to be a great thing, and I think by the second volume that I come out with, hopefully it'll be triple in size, you know, with companies coming out from everywhere. So.
Oh, definitely. You know, that's usually what happens when, as soon as it gets out there and people see, they go, I didn't know nothing about this. So then they start asking about something more, and I think you'll have such a great success with this one, then going on into the second one. I just grabbed some Angry Irishman Chipotle sauce. Oh, amazing stuff.
Oh, nice.
Absolutely great stuff.
Yeah, they sent me their stuff too, and I haven't tried it yet. Obviously, like I said, I couldn't open the bottles yet. So.
Yeah, Marianne and Kevin do an amazing job down there at in Ohio. They've got a new barbecue sauce coming out real soon. That's just absolutely fantastic. Everything that they had, we've tried, and they've been to a couple shows that we have, and just amazing people, amazing sauces, fantastic.
Oh yeah, great people. Everyone that's in my book, you know, we've communicated a lot, and we get to know each other, and we talk, you know. So I just love this industry, man. There's a lot of good people in it. I think the reason why it's such a good industry is everyone knows how much hard work it takes, how much dedication, sacrifice, you know, either working two jobs just to afford the money to get it legit, or taking loans out, and the stress that you put on your families if you have kids or whatnot. You know, that's why I think it's such a good industry, is that everyone kind of knows and respects the process, you know, and it's okay to help each other and give each other advice. So.
Absolutely. And the thing of it is that you can make it or you can't. It's up to you. because there's no one out there saying that you can't make it. It's an open field, so all you got to do is put your face down and really go for it, and anybody can get into this business. And I think everybody that I've seen is so widely welcomed because, like you said, everybody understands the hard work and the stress and everything to bring this product to market. And then it's just almost probably like having a child, you know, like, here we go. I finally did it. This is awesome.
Yeah, exactly.
Now, do you have any Seafire gourmet sauces in your book?
Yeah, that beautiful green sauce that you have right there. I've been dying to try that one, man. I haven't been able to do it yet.
This is amazing.
They just sent me their product.
Yeah, you will love this. This fits right up there with the rest of their sauces. As a matter of fact, I think it's, and not putting the other ones down, but this one I say just about is, man, this is top notch. It's a La Dosa Verde from Seafire Gourmet. I'm going to dab a little bit on this pizza.
So, what are you drinking?
I am drinking some Founders.
Let me see the label on that one.
There we go.
Right there. Okay. Nice.
Yeah, it's just a IPA. Good flavor.
IPA.
Yeah. Fits well with the pizza.
Yeah, I just had an IPA. Now I'm opening a. It's a Campfire Stout by High Water Brewer.
Nice. Now, are they out by you?
Yeah. They make some great beers. I love their products.
What's everybody else drinking out there tonight? Because this is, you know, you got to be drinking beer if you're watching tonight, right?
Exactly.
Now, do you know Kyle Colson from Hellfire?
Who?
I mean, Kyle Colson from Hella Hot Hot Sauces?
Oh, yeah. He's pretty close to me, man. He's a great guy. I met him at the California Hot Sauce Expo.
Okay.
Great dude. I love what he's doing with everything. He kind of has his different themed hot sauces, and I actually got to meet all those people that are on those labels, and it's pretty amazing, man. Like, what he's doing is pretty dope. I love it.
It's kind of like a whack pack of hot sauce right there, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, man, that was excellent. Hella Hot Hot Sauces make some great sauces. Man, I wish I had some of yours right here. I'm going to go dip into a little bit of Keith Jenkins' Frog Bone. Now, you got to have...
Oh, Frog Bone. Yeah, I haven't had them yet.
Okay.
You know, I know he's a busy man, though. You know, like, that's what I'm saying. I respect the business. So there's a lot of people out there that are just busy. You know, he's over there at that event going on tonight, this weekend. And, you know, he has the whole Mardi Gras thing going on. His booth looks amazing. You know, I get it. Everyone gets busy. I don't expect every single hot sauce company to kind of join in on this right away. But I think it's going to catch on. I think it's going to help the industry. So
I do, too. Now, when do you think what's the projected date for this to come to market?
Well, I do have a lot of last-minute people contact me. Even today, I had one contact me today, and they want to send me their product. So it's just a matter of the day I get every single product, you know, here and finalized, and I know exactly what's going to be in the book, then I can get my photography work going, get all the editing going, and my layout. I still have some visions on how I want the layout to be. So it's just a matter of putting in the work after that. But I don't see it taking more than a few months. And that's kind of because I want to rush it. So.
Okay. Looks like, what was that? Do we have a comment on there? My wife just said there's a comment on here. I got to take a look here. Oh, there's a whole bunch of them. Yes, sir. We got a lot of people chiming in, and I really appreciate this. This is awesome. The comparison to craft beer industry is great, and I totally agree.
Yeah. You know, like, that's always been my vision, and, you know, my drive is, you know, it's we put just as much work in as the people in the craft beer, and that's why I think it's a great thing. Like, for instance, where is it at? Actually, I think that might have had it in the other box, but like Voodoo Chili Sauces, you know, he has, oh, it's right here, actually. You know, he has his IPA, you know, mixing craft beers with hot sauces and stuff like that. Like, that's a vision I've had too, but there's companies doing it already. And I think that it just goes well together, you know. It's like, it's the same concept. You're putting in a lot of work and energy and sacrifice into a product.
Absolutely.
And it's more of a craft and art than it is just mass producing something that you don't care about.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And, excuse me, I just got a little hot sauce down the wrong side.
Hey, it's all good. I figured this show would kind of be partial quiet because if we're eating or drinking, and you know, you never know. We'll just roll with it.
Yeah, absolutely. There's a lot of people commenting on here, and can't wait for the book. We need all beer belly, beer bells. Oh, shit. That's from last week's show when the.
From Thomas.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, I told him I need to order one of those bells, man. It's I think his wife was being pretty nice to him because I would have gotten something thrown at me.
Absolutely. I see we have a lot of people joining us right now, and I really appreciate that. We're talking to Enrique Monroy. Monroy. He's got a hot sauce book that he's coming out with. He's a craft hot sauce maker. He has absolutely fantastic hot sauces, and give him a share. Hit down there by the comments. Give him a share to get as much attention to what he's doing here, because he's doing a great service for the hot sauce community. And I have seen some of the pictures that are in this book, and your photographer does a fantastic job. They're just crystal clear, and what a great job.
Oh, well, actually, I appreciate that, but those photos that I post on there for the book are just from my phone. Those aren't actually what's going to be in the book.
Well, they were good. I have to say that.
Yeah. Thank you. I'm pretty good with my phone, so.
Yeah, absolutely.
The pictures for the book, that's what I'm saying. It's going to be that much more intense, you know.
Wow.
I'm actually having a photographer, which is a friend of mine here local. We're going to be working together and creating just something amazing. You know, I'm really excited about it. I think with the products and these companies, like obviously, you know, Mikey B, we got to have the beer and bacon salsa for tonight. But, you know, there's a lot of great companies that make these amazing, beautiful products, and we need to showcase it, you know, and I feel like this book is just going to do that.
Oh, yeah, definitely, definitely. I really feel this is going to be a big seller. I see Susie Owens is on, and she is from Scotty O'Hottie. Susie, we got your sauce here. We're going in right now. This is the beer, bacon, chipotle. I got the mild one because the hotter one is gone. So we're going to dip into that.
Nice.
And they make some fantastic sauces. I mean, you know, this year has brought out such amazing sauces and amazing companies that it's just unbelievable the flavors that people are coming up with. And they're not just, I mean, there's a lot of super hot ones, but there's a lot of them that are in the middle of the road that everybody can enjoy. But even the flavors, no matter what end of the spectrum you're on, is just absolutely fantastic this year. What a great job, or last year, I should say.
Yeah, exactly, and that's why, like, with the book, I still haven't decided yet. Like, I'm not going to come out with one maybe, like, every year. That might be too soon, but I do want to come out with more volumes of it because this industry, it grows every year. You know, like, each company will come out with a new sauce, a new flavor, a new look. And then there's all the new sauces that are coming in, and, you know, later on, they'll be able to come in the book.
Yeah, absolutely, because it seems like once somebody has a sauce that comes out and it seems to catch on, it's not long afterwards that we're bringing out another one, and it's 9 times out of 10, if it's not as good, it's better. People start getting...
That's what's built inside of us, you know, us hot sauce makers, and, you know, it's like you never stop. Like, you have such a passion for this that you create an amazing product, but it doesn't end there. You know, you keep going, you keep creating new things, you have a new vision or, you know, something that you've been thinking about for a while, and you just start experimenting. That's the beauty of this craft.
funny how it, some of the ingredients you can read and you go, man, I can't picture them going together. And then once you get into it and try it, the vision of this, the flavor of the vision the sauce maker had, it just blows you away that they were right. They mixed together so well.
Exactly. Yeah, there's such amazing products out there. It's not even funny. I can't even keep up with it, man. It's just amazing, you know.
Hmm. Got a little Mo Mountain. Great sauce. Now I'm chewing.
Yeah, I have to look at the phone to see the lineup that you have there. That's pretty awesome.
Yeah, I reached in the fridge and just grabbed some randomly out there and brought them up because the flavors are just out of this world. Sorry, I'm
one of So are you like me and you have a fridge in the garage that has only hot sauce and it takes you longer to pick out a hot sauce than it does for you to eat?
Well, I've got two refrigerators full of hot sauces, two cupboards full of hot sauces, and I've got two boxes full of hot sauces. I am no longer allowed in the kitchen with hot sauces because I took over an entire cupboard.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's perfectly
see,
all right.
See, that's the beauty of this. You got to compromise, right?
Yeah. Oh, Stan, Chicago pizza. Chelsea, Mikey V's beer bacon salsa, so good. Is that what you have sitting there? Is that this, the bacon salsa Mikey V's right in front of you?
Yes, yes.
It's great salsa. I just put that up on Taste in the Heat yesterday. It's fantastic.
And do you know how hard it is for me not to eat this?
Well, if you tried it, it would even be harder because if you knew how good it was, that bottle would be open.
Yeah, well, he already knows. I'm going to be ordering some for my personal use. I might have to order a case, though, because I don't mess around when it comes to good salsa, man. It's especially you mix beer and bacon, man. It's just like, why not?
Yeah, exactly. His 7-pot Primo sauce, oh, that will light you up, let me tell you.
Yeah, I have that one, too.
Now, you have... You have Morley's down there at the end, all the way to your left, in the box.
Elijah?
Elijah, yeah. Yeah. Sorry about that. Great sauces there.
Oh, yeah. These guys are amazing, man. It's a good duo, father and son. And they sent me this beautiful package, man. I mean, it opens and closes. When I get it, They go above and beyond, and they send me stuff like this. You know, I'm gonna obviously take pictures of this and put it in the book. It makes me feel blessed that, you know, like what I'm doing, I know it's the right thing, and you know, I have all this support. It's amazing.
Susie from Scotty O'Hadi said that their beer bacon chipotle with scorpion didn't make it in the package because they were sold out. I believe that 100% because if you love their regular beer bacon chipotle and you want a little more heat, that the scorpion is just amazing. I can't even find the regular around here.
Well, hey, until probably the next 2 days, I'm going to completely cut it off. So if there's still time, I mean, just message me. We can work something out. I mean, I have no problem working something out. I get it. We're all human. We run these companies that take a lot more than what people know. And, you know, just reach out to me. Talk to me. I mean, yeah, if there's any questions, talk to me.
At the top of the Tasting the Heat Facebook page, I have your book cover pinned, and you could go right directly to his hot sauce. What's the name of your Facebook page for the hot sauce book?
Oh, Monroy's Book of Hot Sauce.
Yes, that's pinned right to the top of my Facebook page. So if anybody wants to get involved in that, hit him up right away. You can go through it right through there, and you'll be able to instant message him, and you could definitely get in the book if you really hurry. Is that correct?
Yeah. So the deadline was basically the end of February. Obviously, that already happened, but I wanted to do this with you to kind of, you know, clear some things up on what my intentions were with the book, but then also to let people know, like, hey, if you do want to be in the book, this is the last couple days. Just contact me. Let's get it done. I know what's going on. I know how the industry is. I'm super busy. Everything going, trying to run my own hot sauce company and doing all this stuff for the love of the passion. I get it.
You just had a success with your hot sauce with a Safeway. Is that correct?
Yeah. I was very blessed and fortunate to get into a Safeway in Oakland. It was kind of a combination of all the hard work and pushing my product out there at markets and events, festivals, and also kind of luck and timing and, you know, being in the right place at the right time and meeting the right people. And, I got my foot in the door, and, you know, I'm a vendor now at Safeway, and nice. Hopefully with everything that I'm trying to do and push my product for them right now, hopefully I can get into more stores and blow up. You know, that's kind of like the goal that and the vision that all of us have. But it's a lot of work, man, and I appreciate everyone in the industry.
Now, we're going to do a contest tonight for everybody watching. And we have both have a number written down that you've picked earlier. And
yeah,
what is the winner going to get?
When the book's released, I can't give you a certain date yet because there's a lot more work involved in it than me to just tell you that there's a certain date yet right now. But when it's released, I want to give a copy of the book. I'll sign it and I'll ship it to you for free.
That's fantastic. And the number, you got to guess a number between 1 and 50. So go ahead and start guessing, and we're going to both watch it as we talk, eat pizza, and drink beer. I don't know how we'll do this all at once, but I think we can handle it.
Hey, let's drink.
Let's drink. Drink. What a great Friday night, huh?
Oh, yeah.
All right, we have some people guessing here.
So, we got a winner.
We do? No, I don't think so.
Yeah. All right, it showed up on mine.
Oh, did it? Okay. I don't see it.
I can't even pronounce his name right, and I'm Mexican. Guillermo Alfaro.
I didn't see it. I'm sorry.
You don't see it?
No. What number did he pick?
You want me to show you?
Yep, go ahead.
Alright, just so you guys know, I wasn't lying. I wrote it on the pizza box.
That's what we have. Okay, I missed it. Someone else said he said 31, so excellent. Go ahead and either inbox me or inbox the book company or write directly to you, and we will get this information to each other so that this can be done. How's that sound?
Yeah, I'll definitely be reaching out to him for sure.
Fantastic. Now, what's next after the book? You got anything coming up? You got any shows you're going to be doing or anything?
It's all on timing. I got so much going on between, you know, trying to do everything I'm trying to do with my hot sauce company and then getting everything squared away for the book. I got the hot sauce store that, you know, we don't have a permanent location right now, so we're trying to figure things out with that. Family, my kids, it's a lot going on. There's a lot going on, so, I can't really tell you where I'm going to be at, but I do want to try to make as many of the shows, especially when the book comes out.
Absolutely.
I want to hit up a lot of the hot sauce expos and support everything going on with that, and just kind of spread the love. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Now this might be a little advanced asking you this question. Do you know where it's going to be available? Is it going to be on your website, or is it going to be how people could get a hold of it when it comes out, or is that too advanced to figure that out?
Well, So the publisher that I'm working with, they do have contacts with Barnes & Noble, Walmart, and some other places like that, and they're going to help me get my thing rolling with Amazon. So we're definitely going to be available online, so anywhere around the world, especially some of these great products that come from around the world, you know, from other countries. I want their whole fan base to be able to have access to it.
Absolutely.
But nothing's guaranteed. Obviously, it's just a matter of how hard I'm going to push it, how much time and money and effort I'm going to put into it to get it out there to everyone. But my goal, obviously, is to have it at every Barnes & Noble and any bookstore out there so that everyone can enjoy it.
Well, as soon as it does come out and you have a spot where people can click and go to and get it, I'm going to give you 1 year of advertising on tastingtheheat.com so that people can go on there and click and go right to you. This last year I had over 36,000 hits, so hopefully that'll bring some recognition to your book, and I'll definitely throw it up there for you because I want to help you out as much as I can.
Well, I appreciate it, man, and you know, thank you for everything that you do. You know, you kind of have your heart set on the same thing that I do, man. We have a love for the industry and a passion for it, and you know, all we can do is just accept everyone and their hard work, and you know, try to shine light on that.
Absolutely. I gotta grab some Hellfire here. Have you had any of their sauces? Oh,
there's some what sauces?
This is Hellfire, the Pure Hell. This one.
Oh, you know, I just got their package the other night, and I'm like this, like shaking because I can't open it.
It's kind of like a kid on Christmas morning.
Yeah, this is one of their specialty bottles they sent me.
Nice. That's on the wax tops. Yeah. Can everybody see that? That is beautiful.
Wax top signed, everything, and you know, it's so beautiful. I don't want to touch it, but then at a certain point, it's like the chili head inside me wants to open it, but I can't. So, you know,
I've got so many good sauces up here. I know I'm not going to get to all of them, but there's Lucky Dog. There's
Lucky Dog. I actually. I ordered some of his, like, around the same time that he sent his product. I went and ordered he had that special edition where he said something, mistake me if I'm wrong, but, like, he messed up and made it spicier than it was supposed to be. I think that's the special edition that he came out with, or something with the labels, but I ended up ordering it. I was like, hey, let me get a taste of this. So I ordered some of my own, and he sent me some. And, man, I've been... That bottle probably has, it's a big bottle too.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, it probably only has like this much left in it. So.
Yeah, there's a lot of them I didn't get to here. Arthur Wayne, we got Chiba Gold from Seabury, High River, the Lucky Dog. There's just so many good ones here. Gringo Bandito. Oh, I got a good, Gringo Bandito sent me a case of autographed them. Hot sauces. That's Dexter Holland on the label from Offspring. And I'm doing a giveaway right now on my page. I'm giving away four of them. So if anybody wants to try and win them, you can buy Gringo Bandito just about any place, but you can't get them autographed. So I've got four of them I'm giving away. Listen, I tell you what, I thoroughly enjoyed talking to you this evening. Is there anything else that you want to get out there that I didn't cover or anything?
Pretty much covered every base. There was a thing that there was kind of I wouldn't say an issue, but a topic that got brought up with the book. With you know, in the beginning of the book, I was accepting companies to send me their product. And I, without thinking it through, made a decision to reach out to a couple people, or people reach out to me, and they sent me their products, and they aren't legitimate hot sauce companies.
You're still in the beginning phase.
Yeah. So, you know, and that was my vision, is to kind of bring on those products where we all started, and to kind of show the process, but I didn't think it all the way through, and I made a decision after that I'm only going to let legitimate hot sauce companies that went through the process into the book, and, you know, my heart's in the right place. I just want to appreciate everything going on in the industry, and, you know, I My intentions weren't to step on anyone's toes. I know that maybe a couple people were a little frustrated with, you know, what was going on. But if anyone has any questions, you know, just reach out to me. I'm a man. You're a man. We're all human. If there's any kind of questions that you have or topics that you want to talk about, just reach out to me. And I'm, for the most part, I think I'm pretty cool, calm, and collected. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah. You know, and you make decisions along the way, and you have to recorrect a little bit because some things don't work out the way it should. And it's not anything personal or not anything that you're trying to hurt anybody, but sometimes legalities get in there also that you don't have any control over. And you know, I think pretty much people understand that.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Like, you know, my whole thing when I really thought about it and then I sat down with my team and I had some legal advice tell me that, you know, what if you're promoting this product and it's not certified, it's not FDA approved, it doesn't have insurance on it, and then you put that in your book and you showcase it, and then people go online and buy it, then if someone gets sick, they're going to say, well, I found it in my book.
And as crazy as that sounds, it's not crazy, you know.
But what's... Yeah, it sounds crazy, but that's the world we live in.
Exactly.
I mean, everyone's feelings have to be protected. I mean, you can't please them all, you know. And I stay out of politics. I stay out of religion. I don't talk about any of that stuff because I just have a family to provide for. I have a business to run, and I have an industry that I love, and I just want to shine light on it. That's it.
I just got lit up. Burns and McCoy, Extensium.
Burns and McCoy, huh?
Oh, man, it's the pineapple one, pineapple ginger. I'm having a hard time talking right now. This stuff is so good, but it is so hot, amazing hot sauce. You know, every one of the Burns and McCoys that I've had is just amazing stuff. And I just had tried their habanero smoked bacon Bloody Mary mix. I need to put that up on the site. Boy, is that amazing.
Oh, man. I've been wanting to... I'm going to have to actually put in an order for their margarita mix.
Yeah.
The blueberry. That stuff is just sharing my name, man. So, and I think I made a comment on that on their feed when they were at... They're at this event right now. So,
yeah.
You know, I can't wait to put an order in and try it. So.
Whew, I am burning up.
Chase it with a beer.
All right. Everybody, get your beers up. I want to thank Enrique for being on the show tonight. He's got a fantastic book coming out. He's a great guy. Please support him as he supports all the hot sauce industry out there. I think it's a wonderful thing that you're doing, and thank you very much for being on the show.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate it, and we appreciate you.
I am going to say goodnight here, and let me get things rolling. I have to say one thing that Etch and Sketch Glassworks. Get this going here for them. Nope, not up yet. Etch and Sketch Glassworks. It's just amazing the work they do. Have you ever seen any of their work?
Yeah, I've seen it. Mikey V's actually. He uses them, right?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, I seen them. I had a mug, but that event was really fun in California. I think I lost it.
Well, I've got one just like it. This is the Taste in the Heat one. I had one from Mikey V. Oh, here. Nope, I'm not sure where it's at. But it definitely holds two beers, so it's a good deal.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to think.
Hey, just to clarify, the tattoo's real.
Oh, I hold on. Let me get you back up on there. Hold on. We got to show this. I was going to run the... There we go. Okay, you're back up on the screen. Show them tattoos.
It's real, guys.
That is some painful hot sauce tattoos right there.
Hey, that's called going all in.
Absolutely.
If I'm not dedicated, I'm not.
That's awesome. I'm glad we came back to that so you could share that with everybody. All right, everybody. That's it for the evening. We want to thank Enrique for being on the show, and I want to thank Etch and Sketch Glassworks for sponsoring the show. They do fantastic jobs. As you can see, all the great hot sauce companies on there that they have done already. There's so many more. I couldn't get them all up here. Get your name, your logo, your company, whatever you want on anything glass and just about anything else. They do a fantastic job. Go over and see Skip and Chelsea at Etch and Sketch Glassworks.com. That's Etch and Sketch Glassworks with a X at the end. And talk with them. They will do a fantastic job to you. Amazing people, amazing products. And I just want to thank you again for sponsoring the show. Thank you, guys. All right, that's going to just about do it here for us. I want to thank Enrique for being on the show. And good luck with this book. I want to definitely get it out there for everybody. And this is Tasting the Heat. And until next time, keep tasting the heat.